I will continue on from the video earlier. I'll do a little bit on the engine, about where we're at. It's pretty much done. Got the louver finder, temperature sensors on top of the air compressor, which when they come on and they get to about 120 degrees, that automatically bring the fans on in front of the engine. We got fans up in the corner blowing exhaust out. Another two on the box where the air conditioner unit's in. That should be sufficient. I hope to be able to pull it out. Raise the windows, raise the doors, open the doors up. 24 volt alternator come off a Hummer. That's going to be the alternator to charge the batteries up on the inverter as we're going, so we don't have to run the generator. Inverter will run everything but the air conditioning. Pretty much the hot, it will run the hot water heater, but it will not run the wash machine and dryer and dishwasher. But you don't need to run them when you're running on the boat anyway. Sprocket outgoing to the wheel. Number just bolted on the end of the hub. Steering pumps. Got a separate pump for the front rudders and separate for the rear rudders if you do have a failure. There's the electrical for the steering. Looks a little complicated, but not much to it. Just run relays so we can run a small wire up to the pilot house. Also, it can be steered from back here on the front and rear rudders. The safety breakers. Engine control panel. .2 Detroit. Fuel filter, fuel pressures gauges, transmission filter, gauges. That way you can know if your filter is starting to get stopped up by your incoming and outgoing pressures. All the gauges, sending units for all the gauges. It's the rear end. All this come out of school bus. All we did was just chop one side of the axle off, weld the spider gears up in the rear end. Just took two drive shafts and made one out of it. Just a 6-to-1 gear ratio differential. Bolt to the Allison 545. Got the little workbench in. It's pretty, place pretty mess right now. We've been doing a lot of work trying to get it ready. Cables, 50 some wires, 3 cables run all the way up to the front to the pilot house. They all junction here, then they go down and go up. Some of them go up. There's the ones up in the ceiling, the shifter cables and some of the wiring, for the security system. We'll go up into the pilot house. All the switches for inside, outside lights. And what JD Pauly says, that's a cluster. Still haven't got it all finished up. All the switches. Got a lot of spares for your engine start, shutdown, LED lights to let you know when they're on. Green and red lights for the neutral, reds for reverse. Be able to prime the fuel pump, fuel the engine before you start it if you need to. Security camera, TV. All the gauges for the engine. Well, how well you can see that. Voltmeter, oil pressure, oil temperature, water temperature, transmission temperature, differential temperature, fuel pressure, voltmeter for the inverter, tachometer, and another cluster of wires. Everything has to be unhooked to be able to move the boat, so it's not best looking in the world. I'll straighten it all up once we get in the water. This is the steering. Basically, the front one, that's for steering the front rudders, and this is for steering the rear rudders. That's the box for the security cameras. All the main electrical wiring for the pilot house, breakers. There's a 6,000 pound winch on the roof. That's why you see some of the bigger breakers. That's the control box for the winch on the roof, which runs the stage up and down. Still got to do some cleaning up on the air lines for the air horns. Started working on the deck, so when you come out of the pilot house, you got a nice level area, so you don't have a step down, and we'll have to marry the handrails to it. Got it stained, but once I put it together, it had some high low ridges in it, so we just went ahead and sanded it down. Gonna make it where hopefully there'll be a stumble free zone from when you come out of the pilot house to come onto the back deck. Back deck of the boat. Rudder indicators, get them painted so you can see them a little bit better. Paddle wheel. I think the paddle wheel is about 12 by 12, 12 foot wide, 12 foot tall. Stainless steel axle. All the bracing is all aluminum. 160 chain. Brackets to come up and mount it to the roof. Backside, got the ramp for the other side. Got to decide what we're going to do. Probably going to run it on out, let it overhang some off the front, and then we'll put the spotlight. We'll go up on the top of the pilot house. Got the handrail stuck up here temporary. We got to be able to get the front and the rear of the handrails done. Got the air horns. Plates welded on. It was bolted to the pilot house. 6,000 pound winch. Runs out to the stage. Well, that's where we're at right now. Christmas Eve. See what goes on. See what we'll be able to get done next couple weeks. See if it'll be ready. Hope everybody has a wonderful Merry Christmas.